Today I'm wading into 10 of the best middleweight adventure motorcycles money can buy in 2024, and stick around to the end for a few extras. Number 10, the CFMoto 800 MT. Making recent waves in the two-wheeled world, CFMoto has begun thriving in the budget-ish space thanks to the KTM joint venture. Originally hailing from China, CFMoto makes use of KTM engines following a joint venture that started in 2013, and they boast a solid amount of power and tech for your money. This 800 MT comes in three trims. You've got the Sport, Touring, and Explore models, and they all offer a little bit of variation. We'll go with the Touring variant for this list, and it's priced in the middle at a current £9,199. For your money, you get a liquid-cooled 799cc twin with around 89 brake horsepower and 75 newton meters of torque. You get KYB suspension, cornering ABS, and overall, it could be a very solid package for the price. Though the suspension travel is quoted at quite a small 160 millimeters. But don't be deceived by its place on the list at 10. There's plenty to work with here and an equal amount of interest in what could be the next big adventure bike. All for a pretty important solid price that does include full luggage as well. I'll do a quick spec rundown for you as well, as always. So the price is £9,199. The power, 89 brake horsepower. The weight is listed at 231 kilograms. Seat height is 825 millimeters. And the tank size is 19 liters. At number 9, we have the Honda Transalp XL750. So Honda's revival of the Transalp name resulted in hugely positive reviews. And it's powered by the same torquey twin that we sampled in the Hornet last year. And the Transalp pumps out 90.5 brake horsepower and 75 newton meters of torque. It's got four riding modes, configurable ABS, and Honda selectable torque control, plus an additional rider mode. It also has a 21-inch front wheel with spoked wheels. Now, Felix and I were a tad disappointed not to see an off-road focus model appear using this framework, perhaps even a baby Africa twin. But either way, MCM placed the Transalp as the best of the bunch when compared to a couple of others that you will find on this list, and that is praise indeed. And given a few minor tweaks to the components here, like proper knobblies, you would be left with a true off-road conquering weapon. Or as is, it's a grand old place for a long road tour. Spec recap. The price is £9,699. The power is 90.5 brake horsepower. The weight is 208 kilograms. The seat height is 850 mil. And the tank size is 16.9 liters. At number 8, we have the Suzuki V-Strom 800DE. So that neatly brings us to the V-Strom 800DE, which I did try at the launch in Sardinia a year or two ago when I was at Visor Down. That two-day launch had an entire day dedicated to off-road riding, and it was superb fun. Fairly basic, but in the right hands, it's all about what you do with it that counts. Am I right? The V-Strom name goes back all the way to 2002, and it has earned its stripes since then. You can even opt for the bigger 1050 version if you want a little bit more power than the 776cc twin's 84 brake horsepower and 78 newton meters of torque. Focusing off-road though, this handles seriously well, and with switchable off-road mode and ABS, you're in right hands here. It does look really nice in that yellow colorway too. And in my mind, it could just be a little bit better than the Transalp. Now, even if it is a gram more expensive than the Transalp at £10,699, you do also get a quick shifter, Suzuki's intelligent ride system, except even with a 20 litre tank, it is a little bit weighty at 230 kilograms. Spec recap for the DE, £10,699 is your price. The power is 84 brake horsepower, the weight 230 kilograms, seat height is 855 millimeters, and the tank size is 20 litres. Now, no doubt as a keen motorcyclist, you'll need to get insurance on your bike. Now, whether that is a Suzuki V-Strom 800DE or another motorcycle or even a scooter, make sure to pop over to lexhaminsurance.co.uk or click on the link in the top right hand corner to get a quote with them. With over 22 years in the motorcycle game, backed up with a UK insurance team and several exclusive schemes that you can only find at Lexham, you could well find the right cover for you. So make sure to go directly to Lexham for an insurance quote on your bike. At number 7, we have the Husqvarna Norden 901. KTM's offshoot brand, the otherwise tree-felling chainsaw firm Husqvarna, is well known for their ability to take a well-set machine from Austria, give it a unique style, and send it out the door. The Norden does well to base itself off the KTM 890 Adventure and whack on a makeover for budding adventure fans. Priced at £12,899, you get the WP Apex forks with 220 mil of travel, a twin engine with twin balancer shafts with 103 brake horsepower, horsepower and 100 newton meters of torque. You get 21-inch front wheel and an 18-inch rear wheel, and they're trod with Pirelli Scorpion Rally STR tires. You also get free rider modes with the option for Explorer mode. This will tackle practically anything you throw at it. And mentioning that, there's also the Expedition model at £14,599, which hardcore adventurers may take a liking to. It comes with all the technical accessories bolted on. Anyway, tech galore here, and it seriously does well. I do love the style of the Norden. Do you? Or is the KTM better? Quick spec recap for you. The price is £12,899. The power is 103 brake horsepower. The weight is 204 kilograms. Seat height is an adjustable 854 or 874 millimeters. And the tank size is 19 liters. Number six, we've got the Yamaha Tenere 700. Now it does start getting really tricky here. The Yamaha Tenere 700 is in sixth place, but it's an ultimate adventure machine for both touring and days in the mud, with inspiration from the Dakar days of old. The Tenere 700 now has six variations for sale at this point, all at differing price points and with differing tech, but the base model will certainly do the job well. With a 690cc MT07 based CP2, it's a twin with 72.4 brake horsepower and 68 newton meters of torque. Interestingly, this base model Tenere is now priced at £10,110, and the Extreme with much better suspension is £10,900. I'd just go for that. I'd love to see a Super Tenere released with the CP3 triple or bigger. Imagine an MT10 Tenere. Elsewhere, the Tenere is Poltar's weapon of choice, and if you've seen any clips of him riding this, it will fill your head with hopes and dreams of doing the same. He just makes it look far too easy. The newest models are kitted with a 5-inch rally-style dash, long travel suspension, so you've got 210mm at the front, 200mm at the rear, a 21-inch front, 18-inch rear, three modes of ABS and off, and a 6-litre tank. Felix and I did also sample the Ultimate World Raid model with dual-fuel tanks at the ABR Festival 2023. And it's safe to say we loved it. So if anyone does ask me for an adventure bike recommendation, I do always point at the Tenere. It's always up there, but it's not quite the top for 2024 in my eyes. Wait, what have I done putting it so far up at the list in sixth? Do you think it should be higher? Let me know. Anyway, spec recap, £10,110 is the price. Power is 72.4 brake horsepower. The weight is 205 kilograms. Seat height, 875 mil. And the tank size is 16 liters. Could be a bit bigger in my eyes, but just go for the world raid. Now we get to number five and we find the KTM 890 Adventure R. So fifth spot on the list and an absolute weapon from Austria. But you've also got the non-R model, which is a cheaper £12,699, and the 2024 790, which is Chinese built at a very affordable £10,499. If you were lucky to be one of the 700, you could also have got the 890 Adventure R Rally, but that was apparently £20,899. But very spec'd up indeed. Anyway, we'll go with the R, and it's spec'd up with the 899cc parallel twin with 103 brake horsepower and 100 newton meters of torque. The Norden uses this motor. It also comes with all of the rider aids you'll ever need, cornering ABS, revised WP suspension for this year, and infamously the demo mode, where you can try out some of the tech for 1500 kilometers or around 1000 miles or so before you need to pay for it permanently. Even though you do pay a bit on top for the full rally modes, in the right hands, this can get down and dirty. Or upright and sensible for a long tour with the large 20-litre tank. Now, I would be interested to hear what you think of the pay-to-play rider mode stuff, so let me know your thoughts in the comments. Personally, I think it's outrageous that you have to pay to unlock something that's already on the bike. Spec recap, price is £13,999 for this R model. The power is 103 brake horsepower. The weight is 200 kilograms, but that's the dry weight. Seat height is 880 mil, quite tall. And the tank size is 20 liters. Number four, we have the BMW F900 GS. Now this one was freshly updated for 2024 and BMW has upped their game with the F800 and 900 series, with the 900 range given the more adventure-ready spec. The £12,350 F900 GS Adventure is what we'll look at on this list. You could also opt for the £11,995 F900 GS, no adventure. It's a solid package here though, with the 895cc twin producing 105 brake horsepower and 93 newton meters of torque, which is upped in output from the previous range by 10 brake horsepower and a fuller torque curve. Plus it's fitted with rider modes, ABS Pro, a huge 23 liter tank, long travel suspension, 230mm at the front, 215 at the rear, and plenty of opportunity to add more in the BMW configurator, like the dynamic electronic suspension, which sounds pretty cool. Spec is quite appealing on this baby GS, and it looks like a great package for a very appealing price, particularly as this is the top spec model. And that price, £12,350. The power, 105 brake horsepower. The weight, 246 kilograms, which is getting on a bit. Seat height is 875mm. And the tank size is a huge 23 litres, which is probably why it weighs so much. Now, breaking into the top three, we have the Triumph Tiger 900 Rally Pro. So if you keep up to date with us here at Bike Matters, you'll have seen me recently fly off to Malaga for the launch ride of the 2024 Tiger 900 series. And what a bike this is. With variations for road-oriented riders in the GT Pro or off-road extraordinaires in the Rally Pro trim, which we're picking here, this is a superb option for any adventure rider or tourer, whichever one you go for. The spec of the motor is the real reason you want to consider going for the 2024 model rather than any older ones, because Triumph have updated their 888cc triple engine a considerable amount to bring more power, 106.5 brake horsepower, and torque, up to 90 newton meters of torque, yet somehow get the average fuel consumption down. Pure wizardry, if you ask me. Now, the spec includes a 21-inch tire up front, Bridgestone Battle Axe adventure hoops, fully adjustable shower, 45mm forks, 240mm of travel at the front, 230mm at the rear, rally mode and rally pro mode, and a really nice TFT display. It's 228 kilograms as well, by the way. I seriously enjoyed this launch. It's quite possibly the best ever I've been on in all of my years of road testing and reviews. So if you want a full rundown of this Tiger, then watch my review up here. Spec recap for you. The price is £14,495. The power is 106.5 brake horsepower. The weight is 228 kilograms. Seat height is an adjustable 860 or 880 mil. And the tank size is 20 litres. Number two, Ducati DesertX. Now, second place, we find the Italian giant's Ducati sitting pretty with the DesertX. It's a phenomenally capable bike by all stretches of the imagination, the motor, the style, the off-road capability. And in 2024, you'll also find the rally version, which is brand new. This one looks a bit like a stormtrooper, has a wide-eyed gaze, but all the same, it just looks so Ducati. The motor is the Testastretta Desmo, and it produces 110 brake horsepower and 92 newton meters from that 937 twin. You'll also find that same motor on the Monster SP that I reviewed last year. If you fancy watching that, you know where to find it. It's also available in a depowered 47 brake horsepower A24 friendly version, but I'm not sure how many of those are around in the UK. Now, it does tip the scales at 223 kilograms. It's got a 21-inch front and an 18-inch rear, 250mm of ground clearance, six rider modes, including two dedicated off-road modes, and there is plenty of touring potential here. You could even add on an auxiliary 8-litre tank in the configurator, which goes on the back of the bike, if you want to bolster your range potential. Ducati says up to 40% more. The rally model is £19,000 as well, but it gives you the stronger KYB forks over the K-Arba forks found here, and you get bonus off-road spec for those wanting to head out into uncharted lands. Price-wise, for the standard DesertX, £14,995, you may find cheaper alternatives, and Ducati service costs may sting, but from my very, very, very brief ride on one of these, I was just itching for more. Spec recap, I've said the price loads, but £14,995, the power is 110 brake horsepower. The weight, 223 kilograms. Seat height is 875mm. And the tank size is 21 litres. We reach number one. And we find the Royal Enfield Himalayan 450. What? Now, I appreciate this is a middleweight list, and the plucky Himalayan doesn't quite boast the raw power of some others here, but for an overall package, I think plenty of boxes are ticked. Now, hear me out. The motor is updated to the liquid-cooled Sherpa 450 single for 2024, and that's got 40 brake horsepower and 40 newton meters of torque, and it's priced exceptionally well. It starts at £5,850, and you still get an off-road mode with switchable ABS, a nice dash that pairs to your smartphone, 21-inch front wheel, new uprated shower suspension, and a 17-litre tank. Now, my reasoning for putting it at the top spot here is that you could arguably save the money from, say, a Ducati DesertX or other, get yourself some riding gear, money for fuel, and a ticket out of the country, and you can head on a month-long tour of Europe. The new Himi will definitely do it. We've seen Itchy Boots on a pre-production model touring India and the Himalayas, and that's what adventure bikes are all about, right? I'm really keen to get a go on one of these this year, so fingers crossed, and it's just to see if it's really as good as they say. And speaking to some of those lucky enough to head out on the launch in India last year, it certainly does seem to be the real deal, and it's accessible in every way for every rider. So that makes it well worthy of the top spot here in my eyes, but am I being too generous? Let me know in the comments if you agree. Quick spec recap here. Himalayan starts at 5 £5,850. The power is 40 brake horsepower. The weight is 196 kilograms. Seat height is 825 mil. And the tank size is 17 litres. A few bonus picks as well that didn't quite make it onto the list, but are well worth a mention. We've got 10.1, the CFMoto 650 MT. It's a solid option for a budget. £4,999. So give that a look. 10.2, we put the Zero DSRX. Now, the electric option here, that may not translate properly to adventure riding, just simply due to the availability of plug sockets out in the middle of nowhere. But it rides really well. At 10.3, we've got the Moto Guzzi V85 TT. An inverse Italian twin. It's not quite a proper adventurer, but it's a great bike to ride. And don't listen to the people who say it's low on power. It's fine. 10.4, we've got the Aprilia Tuareg 660. Another Italian, the Tuareg is a solid bike for off-road riders. Well worth a look. And at 10.5, we have the MV Agusta LXP Orioli. It's a new option that we spotted launched at EICMA in 2023, and it will be built in limited numbers, around about 500 only. And it carries a huge price tag, around 30,000 euros or... I've worked out at £25,600, roughly. Pretty to look at, though. And if you want something else to watch, what about the Festival for Adventure Bike Riders? Click up there to find it. Felix and I went to the ABR Festival in 2023 and basically gave you a rundown on what to expect for this year. Maybe we'll see you there this year. Really appreciate you watching this far. Let me know your favourite from the list, or just of all time, in the comments down below. If you own one of these on the list, where would you put it on the list? What's it like to ride? What's it like to own? Give us a like, share the video with your adventure pals. Stay tuned for the heavyweight list, which is going to be coming soon enough. And subscribe to Bike Matters for more. Ciao.